Moom, I want more cake.
Sure, honey.
More.
Okay, here you go, honey.
I want a burger, too.
Okay, dear.
Pizza, now!
Yes, honey.
I was a really fat kid, and I had no limits. I sort of looked like Patrick from SpongeBob SquarePants. And what made it worse was that was actually my real name. None of this bothered me much when I was little because there's not much peer pressure when you're that young. Of course, I got teased a bit at school, but that didn't matter to me. What mattered to me was that there was cake at home and ice cream. So who cared if Karen Jr. thought I was taking up too much space? But that began to change through middle school. Middle school kids are worse, and I began to feel self-conscious. I started looking at myself in the mirror, and I felt very uncomfortable. Was that really me? I was bigger than a small dinosaur. I became sad and shy, because kids do experience these feelings sometimes, you know? My parents started to get worried about me, so my mom sat me down to have a talk one night.
What's wrong with you, my adorable, cuddly teddy bear darling boy?
I don't want to be cuddly or a bear. I'm a boy. I'm so fat, Mommy. The kids tease me and the girls don't like me.
Girls? Why are you thinking about girls at your age?
I'm 12, Mom. All my friends have crushes now, but none of my crushes will talk to me. It's because I'm fat, isn't it?
No, something is wrong with them.
Something is wrong with me, I whined.
Okay, fine, son. If you're so uncomfortable, we can do something to change that. You're going to have to change your diet, and you'll have to start exercising regularly.
No!
If you want to change, you have to work hard. That's the only way.
She shrugged and left the room. I sat there all alone, looking at my belly rolls and feeling like a whale. I decided then and there that this type of life was coming to an end. I had my mom donate all our junk food to the less fortunate. Then we went to the supermarket and bought healthy stuff. Fruits, vegetables, whole grains, that sort of stuff. It was really hard to adjust to the change at first, because it's hard to happily munch on carrots when you're used to cookies being a food group. My mom bought me some gym equipment too, because I was too shy to go to the gym. For months, I ate no junk food and I worked out twice a day. I became a total hottie, but I only realized the huge change at a family Thanksgiving dinner. My aunts and uncles and all their children flew over to spend the evening with us at our house. My grandparents were there too, and every time someone opened the door, their reaction was different.
Is this Patrick's friend? He's so cute.
Oh my gosh, Patrick, what happened to you?
Who are you, and what have you done with my grandson?
At dinner, I was the main topic. Everyone kept telling me how handsome I looked and how proud of me they were. It was one of the best feelings I had ever experienced, but it also made me dependent on constant reassurance from people about how good I looked. So anyway, years passed, and it was finally time for high school. I was still gorgeous, by the way, but even more so. I had muscles, a six-pack, the whole shazam. I asked my parents if I could go to a high school outside of our town where less people knew me. I wanted a fresh start, away from anyone who knew what I looked like in the past. They agreed, and before I knew it, I was a high school celebrity. I became a total chick magnet in no time. It wasn't hard to make friends at all. I joined the football team to seem even cooler, and because I was so fit now, I made a really great player. When I played, all the cheerleaders would drool over me, even those who were in relationships. My football friends introduced me to some of the most popular girls at our school. The prettiest one was Jenny, but she already had a boyfriend. Her best friend Sandra seemed like she was really into me though, so we started going out. She was my first girlfriend, and the girl who taught me all about dating. I tried my best to be a good boyfriend. We hung out after school and went to the movies almost every weekend. What I loved most about her was that she was constantly telling me how good I looked. Then, one night while we were strolling home after the movie, she mentioned something which made my heart jump.
Hey, do you know that Jenny broke up with her boyfriend Chad? He was cheating on her. So awful.
What? That's good.
What's good about that?
Nothing. When I got home, I decided to send a message to Jenny right away. I just pretended to be the caring, concerned friend. But what I really wanted was to find out if she'd consider going out with me. What? Don't judge me. She's the one I originally wanted anyway. Would you believe that she agreed to meet me after school the next day, even though she knew I was dating her friend? I suppose that's the advantage of being hot. You can get any girl you want. I told Sandra that I had an upset stomach and I couldn't hang out with her that day because I was going to bed. Then I met Jenny and took her to my favorite restaurant downtown. It was nothing fancy, just burgers and fries. But I regretted eating that later and I worked out for an extra hour. I was totally lost in Jenny's eyes, and I couldn't believe how beautiful she was. In no time, she agreed to be my girlfriend. I told her that I broke up with Sandra, but she shouldn't say anything to her because it would hurt her feelings. Sandra didn't suspect a thing. So I had two girlfriends, and they were best friends. Then my life took a more complicated turn that summer. My parents had been planning to tour around Europe for a while, and it looked like their plans were finally coming together. On my last day of school, my mom and dad handed me an itinerary with so much excitement in their eyes. You mean we're going to be gone for 2 whole months?
Yes, dear.
Awesome. I said goodbye to Sandra and Jenny the same night. I met Sandra a little earlier, then told her I had to run home to pack. But I really went to meet Jenny after, because I wanted to spend more time with her. Anyway, before I knew it, I was in France. I went to many different tourist attractions with my parents, but after a while, I started to feel bored. I mean, if you're a teenager and you're like me, you probably don't enjoy spending every second with your parents. So after we were settled a bit, I started going out by myself. I enjoyed walking around just looking at everything. But one day I got a bit tired, so I decided to stop at a cozy little cafe. I ordered a cup of coffee and a cool-looking pastry. And as I was looking around for a seat, I saw the most beautiful girl I had ever seen in my life. I decided to take a chance and ask her if I could sit with her. Hey, is this seat taken?
No.
Oh, you speak English. That's great.
Yes, I do.
She had a cute little accent, which I couldn't get over. She told me her name was Celine and that she lived nearby. I asked her if she'd go out with me on a date the next day, and she agreed. She planned the date because it was her country. We went to a cute little garden, then I had a romantic little lunch. I enjoyed every moment, and I even kissed her goodbye when it was time for me to go back to my hotel. The next day, we went to the Louvre, because she decided that I absolutely had to see it. While we were looking at some interesting art pieces, I held her hand and asked her if she'd be my girlfriend. She agreed, and we kissed again. What? I was in the city of love, so do you really think that Sandra and Jenny were on my mind? The next day she was busy, and I decided to go back to the Louvre by myself because there was something I wanted to check out. I was so caught up with Celine the day before that I felt like I missed something. What? I'm a jerk, but yeah, I do like art. Anyway, while I was staring into space, I felt a light tap on my shoulder. I turned around, and my jaw dropped. If I thought Jenny and Celine were beautiful, this girl was on a whole other level. Hi, I trembled.
You've been staring at this for a long time? What are you thinking?
I looked into her eyes, and I was so mesmerized that I couldn't speak.
Come with me. I'll take you to another museum. It's even cooler than this one.
I decided that she was too pretty to be a serial killer, so I followed her. She told me her name was Chloe and that she was from the south of France, but her parents sent her to a boarding school in England so she could learn English. She was on vacation for the summer, just like me. I took her back to the hotel and introduced her to my parents. Then we all went for a fancy dinner together. I had so much fun with her that we exchanged numbers, and by the end of the week, yep, you guessed it, she was my girlfriend too. So now I had 4 girlfriends. I said goodbye to Celine and Chloe the night before my parents and I left for Spain. At different times, of course. They both cried, and I thought it was so cute. Anyway, in Spain, we stayed at my parents' friend's house near the sea, and they had a really hot daughter named Gabriella. To cut a long story short, she eventually became my girlfriend too. I just loved that thrill I got every time a new girl desired me. So the same thing happened in Portugal. Her name was Laura. And Germany. Her name was Mila. So I was up to 7 now. When I got back home, I sort of felt relieved. I didn't even tell Sandra and Jenny I was back. I just switched off my phone for 2 days so I could get a break. But when I turned it back on, it was time for business. I decided to meet Jenny first because I missed her the most. I told Sandra I was recovering from food poisoning caused by awful German sausages and went to Jenny's house. But when Jenny opened the door, my jaw dropped. Standing next to her was a girl who was 10 times prettier than she was.
This is my cousin, Carlene.
Hi, Carlene. I'm Patrick.
Patrick? Like the starfish? What a funny name.
I was in love. Later that night, I got a message from her saying that she got my number from Jenny's phone. She asked me if I'd meet her for lunch the next day, and I agreed. We met at a food court in the mall, and we had the most adorable conversation ever. Then I saw her wave to someone nearby.
Hey, my friend Desiree is coming to join us for a while. You don't mind, do you?
No. But when Desiree sat next to me, my eyes nearly fell out of my head. She was gorgeous. And I seriously couldn't concentrate because I was sitting with 2 beautiful women. and I was just confused. It seemed like Desiree was really into me too. And when Carlene got up to go to the bathroom, she asked me for my number. I texted them both every night for a while, and I'd meet them sometimes for romantic strolls wherever. Eventually, they both became my girlfriends. So yep, we were up to 9. I guess I became too confident because I became less careful when I snuck around. It was also hard to talk to all 9 of my girlfriends consistently. One night, while Desiree was sitting in my living room with a huge bowl of popcorn, and we were just about to make out, the doorbell rang. I opened it, and there was my German girlfriend. She jumped into my arms and started kissing me. Then Desiree came over and dumped the entire bowl of popcorn on her head. At that moment, Jenny and Carlene came over, and when they realized what was going on, they all started fighting with each other. I managed to separate the fight and get them to stop. But they were so upset with me that they all left and started posting horrible things about me on social media. Now, all my other girlfriends knew that I had been cheating on them, and people started making all kinds of funny memes about me. It was awful. The next day, I woke up with a headache and looked outside of my bedroom window. It seemed like a new family was moving in next door. I went downstairs to ask them if they needed help, and then I saw her, holding a box with a twinkle in her eyes.
Hi, my name's Annie.
My heart melted, and very soon, I had my 10th girlfriend.